So we have here today the Nikko TRM-750. It's a handsome amplifier, integrated amplifier. Nikko's a bit of a sleeper brand. I think they were a bigger thing in West Germany back in the day than they ever were in the US, but they did make inroads into the US market. I've featured this one before in my video comparing phono preamps, and it has a good phono preamp. Often when I play this amplifier, it sounds really good. And then it will stop sounding good. There'll be static in one speaker or the other. The last time I was using it and had static in one of the speakers, it was the left speaker. I think previous to that, it's been the right speaker. It's not consistently in one channel or the other, and it's not particularly reproducible. Sometimes it's staticky, sometimes it's not. So that's kind of frustrating, and so I've been trying to figure out how to fix it. It's difficult to fix something when you can't reproduce the problem. So, I had one suggestion from somebody else who owned this same amplifier on Instagram, and he said, you gotta clean these front panel switches, make sure they're good and clean. So I'm gonna do that. I've done a bunch of stuff to this amp. You can see it's got these post-it notes all stuck to it. Those are descriptions of some of the things that I've done to it, but also taking note of some of the problems that persist. So the thing is that when it's staticky, it doesn't seem to be associated with any switch or knob. That is, the last time it was staticky, I could not affect it with really anything except the volume knob, which is a key thing. So I couldn't affect it with the tape monitor switches, with the loudness switch, couldn't affect it with balance other than to, you know, make that speaker go quiet. Couldn't really affect it with bass and treble too much, not appreciably. Changed the tone of it, but couldn't affect it with any of these buttons, the low filter, the high filter, the mono, the muting. Well, the muting, of course, muted it, but big deal. Like I said, the one thing that did have a strong effect was the volume. It got, the static got loud when I turned up the volume. So that tells me that the problem is upstream of the volume knob, because everything downstream of the volume knob isn't affected by the volume knob. Only the signal coming in is attenuated or not by the volume knob. So I know that the static, at least the last static problem that I've had with it, it was, I know a couple of things, that it was present in every selector function, and that I could turn the volume of it up and down. So that means that it's, that static is present in the signal coming to the volume knob, and it's not in the phono preamp because it's present in all of these things. So there are a few things that, looking at the schematic, that could encompass. The loudness switch is upstream of the volume, and the monitor and dubbing switches are upstream of the volume. So I'm going to clean those switches. I'm going to have to take them off the board, take them apart to some degree at least, and clean those out. But I kind of don't think it's the switches. I think that it's probably a transistor. And that's because it the static doesn't seem to be affected by the switches. If the static is coming from a switch, then manipulating the switch ought to affect the static at least a bit. And it doesn't. So I think it's a transistor. The other thing that I've done in order to try to find a fix for this amplifier is to try to figure out whether any of the transistors in here are generally known to be bad transistors or failure-prone transistors. And there are two transistors in here, or I should say, two single transistors and two double transistors that are known to be problematic. The double transistors make up the differential pair to the power amp input, and they're definitely therefore not the problem that I'm having. Those double transistors are simply prone to failure, not prone to produce noise, not prone to sounding bad, simply prone to failure. And if they fail, then I simply won't get sound out of one of the channels. So that's not the issue. The other transistor is the front-end transistor on the preamp. It's the one transistor that's upstream of the volume knob and downstream of the selector switch. And it's known to throw static bursts, which sounds exactly like the problem that I'm having. The transistor in question is the 2SC1400. This is a high gain transistor. That is, its gain is 350 to 700. It's a relatively low current, relatively low power. So 50 milliamp max current, 250 milliwatt max power dissipation, collector to base max voltage of 100 volts. One of the transistors that's recommended as a replacement is the KSC1845. This is a favorite transistor, but it's also been really hard to come by since the pandemic. Well, I finally got some. I got these as samples from OnSemi. I got all of these from OnSemi for the cost of shipping and handling, which wasn't particularly cheap shipping and handling. It was like $11 or $12, though. Not too bad. The KSC1845 has been out of stock on DigiKey and Mauser, but I was able to get it direct from OnSemi. I measured the gain on all of these, and I've written it down on here. These all have the same gain, 428. That's in the range that we want. This is the transistor we want. So in addition to dismantling some of these switches and cleaning them up, I am going to replace those two transistors. They are transistors Q501 and Q502. So they are on the equalization board. They're right here. I'll show you in a sec. All right, we're inside the amplifier now. Here are two of the switches that I need to remove and clean. And here is one of the transistors in question. And here is the other transistor in question. I've replaced a lot of things already on this amplifier. You can see all of these green Nichicon Muse bipolar electrolytic capacitors. You can see these film capacitors that I've put here at the input to the preamp in place of the electrolytic caps that were there before. I've replaced all of the electrolytic caps in this amplifier. I've replaced the trimming pots for setting the bias and the DC offset here, here, and here, and here. You can see that something happened here. And I'll show you a picture of what this board looked like before I worked on it and what the old pot or trimmer pot looked like. These are all 20 turn pots, which provide a lot easier fine tuning of settings than the previous part turn pots. So I'm going to need to take this board out. I'll need to take the bottom off, of course. Since I'm going to have to take that board out, I'm going to have to take off the front panel and all the knobs and everything. Pan around the whole inside of the amp here. Got a nice big power transformer, big old power filter cap. That's the one capacitor that I've not changed. I may still need to replace that at some point, but then again, maybe I won't. Got this board partially out to work on it, and I was just looking at the pin order on the transistors that I'm going to replace. They're in order of emitter, collector, base. Those are marked on the board. Kind of most important thing to do when you're replacing transistors is know the pin order that needs to go in the board and what you've got here, and I've marked the pin order here, and I've got a tester. I'll double check that before I put them in, just to make absolutely sure that I get everything in the right spot. These transistors out. I'm going to put them in my transistor tester here. It's telling me that pin 1 is the emitter, pin 2 is the collector, pin 3 is the base, which is how it's marked on the board. And the gain is 456. I believe this is essentially the diode drop from base to emitter, 646 millivolts. Interesting, this one has a gain of 579. Still, same pins, okay, all good. So now I'll get a couple of these KSC1845s. Stick these in the tester again. Make sure my notation on the envelope is good. It is telling me the same gain that I measured before, but it's telling me emitter collector base for pins 1, 2, and 3 respectively, which is not how I have it marked on the envelope. Well, I'm glad I checked that. Check another one just to double check. Yeah, emitter collector base. Same gain that I measured previously. So I'm glad that the pinout is what it is, because it will go on the board in exactly the same orientation as the old one did.
Most of all, you funk. Don't get down to funk. Most of all, you funk. That's the way I like it, baby. I don't wanna live forever. And don't forget the Joker.
To reproduce or observe the problem with this amplifier on a scope. So I brought it right out here to the test rig. Sounded good.
Pushing up the ante, I know you got to see me.